5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. We have a liftoff. Liftoff on Apollo 11.
The legacy of Apollo permeates every aspect of planetary science and the study of our solar system.
Equality base here. The angle has landed.
A lot of what we know about the moon comes from the samples collected by the Apollo astronauts from the surface of the moon, brought back to Earth to be studied in the laboratories. And all the things that we've learned from studying those samples, those things have allowed us to then extrapolate and understand the other planets in new and different ways.
With Apollo, it was flags and footsteps. So we got there, put the flags on the ground, we did some good science, but we went away.
It's one small step for man.
We're beyond the one small step.
3, 2, 1, boosters in ignition.
Now we're into the giant leap part of it. Indeed, Apollo was a small step. It was a toe in the water of space exploration. So now we're going to do a complete dive into the pool. This is about putting footsteps into the solar system to be permanent explorers.
Traveling at 1,420 miles per hour.
Artemis is the twin sister of Apollo in Greek mythology, and the goal for Artemis 3, the first landing on the moon in the mid part of this decade, is to bring the first woman and the first person of color to the moon. So diversity of our space program has really been an important goal. We want to inspire the next generation. We want to inspire kids who look up at NASA and see astronauts and say, these astronauts look like me. I can do this. I can be part of the space program. It's wonderful to finally, after all these years waiting, to see our next human-rated space vehicles going to the moon.